العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome again my dear respected brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our meeting. May Allah Azza wa Jal benefit us from whatever we learn, whatever we teach, whatever we read. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this knowledge testify for us at the day of judgment, not against us. So today, inshallah, we'll continue tafsir ayah 113. Inshallah, explanation of the meaning of ayah number 113 to two, sorry, 200, 213 to till 215, inshallah. And here, the first ayah, as you see it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قال عز وجل, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, كان الناس أمة واحدة فبعث الله النبيين مبشرين ومنذرين وأنزل معهم الكتاب بالحق ليحكم بين الناس فيما اختلفوا فيه. This is part of the ayah because we divided the ayah to more than one part to make it easy for explanation. Mankind was of one religion before their deviation. Then Allah sent the prophets as bringers of good tidings and warners and sent down with them the scripture in truth to judge between the people concerning that in which they differ. Now let's go to the meaning of this ayah word by word as you see it here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, mankind, that means all mankind from the time of Adam. Now talking about the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he created Adam, and then he came down to this earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him. So Adam alayhi salam, who was the first prophet, and you know, Noah is the first messenger. So Adam and his children, they were Muslim. They were believers. And then they stay for this, as mentioned in some reports, like from Ibn Abbas, who said that they stay all in the straight path as long as for 10 centuries. 10 centuries, that means about 1,000 years. And they were Muslim. There was no disbelievers. So the ayat said here, كان الناس أمة واحدة, mankind of one religion. فبعث, you see the ayat doesn't here, you see this, that you see between the paragraphs before their deviation, it's not included in the ayat. But it is understood. It is understood because there's, if you read the ayah in Arabic, there is one heading verb, one heading verb, which should be, كان الناس أمة واحدة فاختلفوا. Mankind were of one religion, they were one nation, and then they differ. They deviated. And this is what was explained in the English translation. So after, when we said one nation, that means they were all in the same religion. And this religion, as we said, it is Islam. This is very important to understand. Islam is not a new religion. Islam is the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the beginning till the end. Because Islam is not, you know, labels with or related or linked to a person or to place, like for example, to Judaism, to Judah, this is place or a kingdom for the people of Israel sometime. Or when you say Christianity, following the name of Christ, or Buddhism, this is, you know, no. Islam is mean, and all of you, brothers and sisters, you know what does it mean, Islam? It mean to surrender to the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala. To submit to the command of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Islam in this mean also peace and tranquility that the person find between what? Between his mind, his soul, and his body, when he followed the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the person, any man, woman, they follow the religion of Allah, the teaching of Allah, the teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah, they will find harmony. They will find tranquility. Why? Because there will be no contradiction or fighting between what the mind want, what the soul want, and what the body want. All of them, they are, you know, going in the same way. And this is the blessing of Islam, that you feel, as they say, peace of mind. You feel tranquility. Why? Because you know your way. Because you have guidance. Because you have light. Because your soul is already connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And your mind and your body and every part of you are controlled by your faith, not by your desire. Because man was created to be slave. Like it or not, he was created to be a slave. If he was not slave for Allah, servant in Allah, then he will go and serve something else. He will serve his desire, either money, either woman, either power, whatever. So the peace of mind that the human being find it only in following the religion of Allah, the teaching of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the revelation. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is here tell us about our history as mankind and said people were all, they were created as Muslims. And this was confirmed by the Hadith Qudsi of the Prophet sallallahu which was reported that said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam reported about, narrated about Allah Azza wa Jalla, who said, خَلَقْتُ عِبَادِي حُنَفَاءَ فَاجْتَلَتْهُمُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. The meaning of this Hadith Qudsi, Allah Azza wa Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, what did he say? He said, I created my servant all in the straight path, hunafa. But devils, satanics, desire, whatever, took them away from the straight. Excuse me. So, from this we know that the original nature of people, that they were Muslim. Excuse me. And then what happened? They deviated. And then Allah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم also told us in other hadith, كل مولود يولد على الفطرة. Every born child, every born baby, born in the state of fitra. Fitra, that's mean on the straight way, in the straight path. فَأَبَوَاهُ يُهَوِّدَانُ أَوْ يُمَصِّرَانَهُ أَوْ يُمَجِّسَانَ. And then come the effect and the influence of what? Of the environment surrounding. And the first environment is what? The family. So the Prophet ﷺ is saying, every born baby, in fact, born in the state of Islam. If he was left, nobody interfered in his mind, in his choice, he will choose to believe in the one God, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by himself. But then his parents, abawahu, that means his mother or father, may turn him to Judaism or Nasrani or to Christianity or Majisani or to, you know, worship any other, follow any other religion. This is why we said when a person returned to Islam, we don't say it convert, we said revert. Why? Because in fact, you return to your innate nature. You return to the way that you was before the surrounding environment changed your way and took you away from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the people after Adam, they stay for 10 centuries. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then they started the deviation. How did this deviation start? You know, the shaitan was working throughout this time to change the people, to take them away from worshiping Allah. So the next, the latest generation, they were very weak and they are ignorant. This is the most important. When people become ignorant, the shaitan or anyone may misguide them. So the shaitan came till it was there are only few people who are very righteous among them. And when it's the time of Noah, few people. And those righteous people, all the people respected them, those individuals. So when they died, the shaitan started his plan. He came to the people, they said, these people, they are very nice, they are righteous. And now they go. How can I remember them? Let's make statues for them, pictures. So just to remember them, not to worship them, just to remember them. They remind us about the truth. So they made for them pictures and statues. And then after this generation, who know that what the purpose of doing this, to remember the righteous, he came to the next generation because they are ignorant and told them, your forefather, they used to get closer to God by worshiping these pictures, by worshiping these statues, these idols. So they deviated. Look to the deviation, how it started. And then the following generation, they forget everything. They thought those are their gods. This is the deviation. It's happened always. It starts very, very little, very small. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ النَّبِيِّينَ. So Allah, فَبَعَثَ فَا, as he said, here to say, when they deviated, Allah sent the messenger. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about النبيين. He said, فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ النَّبِيِّينَ. He didn't say messengers. And there's difference between a Nabi and the messenger. The messenger is the one who come with law and he get or receive scripture from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the prophet, he will apply the law or the teaching of the messenger that's come ahead of him. Like, you know, so that, like all these, the prophets of the children of Israel, all of them, they use to rule the Israelis by what? By the law of the Torah. So this is the difference between prophets and messenger. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that he will send in every community. But here it said, فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ النَّبِيِّ مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنذَرِينَ. Those prophets who were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by chosen by Allah Azza wa Jalla, what was their task? What was their mission? مُبَشِّرِينَ, that means give glad tidings. Glad tidings to whom? To those who follow the straight path. And also, they are warners. Warner for what? Warning people from not, you know, following their desire. Warning them from the hellfire. Warning them from the end of disbelief and deviate from the straight path. So, مبشرين ومنذرين. And then, because the prophets, when they come, or the messenger, when they come, he come with these two tasks. Why? Because there are some people who will accept the truth. They will become a Muslim. And then they will be given the glad tidings that there is Jannah waiting for them. There is forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is mercy from Allah. Give them glad tidings, good news. That's preach them or tell them about there's good ends. The other side, there are some people, they may object. Some may are the stubborn minded. They want to follow their desire. They will reject. So for those people, there is warning for them. Warning them that if you continue this way till you die, that means you will be thrown in the hell. Because at the end, on in the day of judgment, or after this life, there's only will be two places, either paradise or hell. So the one who doesn't follow the messengers, he will be followed. And then he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنزَلَ مَعْهُمَ الْكِتَابِ. Send down with them the scripture. With whom? The ayat said, النبيين, prophets. But in fact, scriptures sent to whom? To messengers. So the ayah is talking about prophets in general. Why? Because every messenger is a prophet. Every messenger is prophet. But not every prophet is messenger. So Allah Azza wa Jal include all those that he sent. And then he specified those messengers who were given the scriptures. Al-Kitab, the book. And this, the word book here, refers to whatever book Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. It's not here mentioned to the refer to the Quran only. Refer, أنزل معهم الكتاب. All these messengers who came, they received book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like the Torah for Musa alayhi salam, the Psalms for David, like for Suhuf Ibrahim, like for the Gospel for Isa alayhi salam, and the Quran for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every messenger come, he come with a book. And from this, he said, أنزل معهم الكتاب. أنزل with them. That means when he send this messenger, he will give him a book. This is what you call it al-ma'iyya, together. So you will get a book, revelation, teaching, and you'll get a model, teacher, someone who get this, explain it to you, give you the example, how to practice. And this is the mission of the messenger. This is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, always remind the people to follow his example. He said, "Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli." As you know, there is a certain practice, you know, like this is skills. You cannot describe it by word. You need practical example, like a salah. If you explain to some three or four people how to pray, they will pray, but you will see there are different prayers. Maybe they will agree in some, but in general, there will be some differences. This is why you need one model. And this is come through what? The example of the messenger. عليه الصلاة والسلام قال صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. Pray as the way that you are seeing me pray. So this is the purpose. So the book, every messenger come. He come to teach. He come to guide. He come to show how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in truth, which means this book which come to show the truth, which means to show or to tell the people that anything else other than this truth will be deviation. So nothing will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except what was following his command and his revelation. This is why the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam many times warned us against deviation or innovation. He said, من عمل عملا, من, as he said, من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. Anyone, no matter who is he, anyone who invents in our matter, which means in religion, in Islam, anything which is not part of it, he innovated, then it will be rejected, will not be accepted. And the other warning, which is very clear, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Every innovation, anything that's new introduced in the religion will be considered as innovation. And any innovation in the religion is what? Misguidance. And every misguidance will lead to what? To death. And the Prophet ﷺ used to repeat this statement in many of his speech, that even sometimes he end his speech or he start his speech with it at Eid and Friday time also. What the purpose of the book? The purpose is to rule. That's mean the revelation that Allah Azza wa Jalla sent down to us, like in the Quran, for example. The main important function for the revelation is to rule between the people. And the ruling here, it's come in a form of command or prohibiting or explaining about the way of worship. So all this truth, you'll find it only in the book. Talking about ourselves here, we find it in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So anything which is not in the revelation, it will be innovation. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said that this book to judge between people in the matters that they dispute about. Dispute, when you said dispute, that means you have more than one view, more than one opinion. This is the meaning of dispute or differences. So when people have different views or different opinions, they see someone, and when they want to take a decision, they need someone to tell them which one has the right, as we do when we go to the court sometimes when we have differential problems. So for a Muslim, for a believers, they should turn to what? To the Quran or the Sunnah. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. قال عز وجل وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ فَإِنْ اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. You should obey Allah. Obey His Messenger. The word obey repeated with Allah and with the Messenger. And then Allah عز وجل add, and those who have authority among him. That's mean ruler. That's mean judge. That's mean government. So all these rule, they have authority. But then what he said, but if you have dispute, then return it to whom? Return it to Allah and His Messenger. Then the judgment only in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب. The next part of the ayah said, وَمَا اخْتَلَفَ فِيهِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ. And don't differ over it after the scriptures come. There should be no differences. All people, they should come together. But there are some, except those who were given it after the clear proofs came to them. Out of what? Out of jealous animosity among themselves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying here that this book or revelation which was sent to these people and should get them together, united them after they were differed, they will lose and guided them to the truth. Some will take it, but some of them, they will follow their own desire. they will reject. They are stubborn. They are following their, you know, different reason. They will not follow the truth. They will insist on their misguided that you get used to it. Either because they are imitating the way of their fathers or their parents or their community. They don't make their head work as a human being and think to see the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it here very clearly. They differ after al-bayyinat. Bayyinat means it's very clear. Very clear. There's no doubt. It's not ambiguous. Bayyinat. Provided. Supported by proofs that this is the truth. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sent any messenger, for example, he provided him with miracles. Like when he sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, during his lifetime, he showed many miracles to the people to show that he is a messenger of God. And then the Quran itself is the great miracle. Nobody can, you know, say this Quran or this book could be made by any human being or anybody else other than Allah. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. If this book was not from Allah, then they will find some many things, many differences. But this is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Al-Bayyinat. All this proofs, evidences, clear proofs that show the truthfulness of this messenger and the truthfulness of this book, that it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they're just a matter of aggression, you know. And even nowadays, there are many people, they know that Islam is the true religion. Even among priests, among some religious leaders, but they don't want to follow it. Not because they think it is not right, but because they are jealous. How come this religion is not in our community? It did not start in our culture. Or they are stubborn, they want to follow their way. And you know, even there, we mentioned many stories that the Jew at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they knew that he was the awaited messenger. Some of them, many of them, they embraced Islam. But there are some of their leaders, they didn't. Intentionally, they know that it is the truth, but they didn't follow it. And this is what is exactly was mentioned in this ayah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فهد الله الذين آمنوا لما اختلفوا فيه من الحق بإذنه والله يهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. And Allah guided those who believed to the truth concerning that over which they had differed by His permission. And Allah guides whom He wills to straight back. So those who believe in this book that was revealed to the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the ones who were guided. And you remember we mentioned about guidance of two types. The guidance, الدلالة والتوفيق. What's the difference between دلالة and توفيق? Guidance of توفيق, that means guidance that come from Allah alone. That's opened the heart and the mind of this person to accept the truth. Because some people, because they don't deserve to get this light, this truth, because they are stubborn, they are sinking their desire. And you know, they reject the truth because they just want to follow their own way. Allah will not open their heart. They will leave them. But anyone who sincerely thinking about finding the way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jal is very merciful. He will guide him. And this is what Allah Azza wa Jal said here in this ayah. So when those guided and accepted the truth, then there will be no differences. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided them, opened their mind and their heart, and they accept the revelation, they accept the teaching of the messenger, therefore there will be no difference among them. Why? Because there is road map for them how to live, how to act, how to deal with others. This is what we have in Islam. In Islam, alhamdulillah, Islam is a way of life. It is a way, it is code that give you guide or manual how to deal with everyone. Know the rights of everyone. Know the rights of Allah who created you. The rights of yourself. The right of your wife. The right of your children. The right of your parents. The right of your neighbor. The right of your relatives. The right of the other human being. Even the rights of animals and birds and environment. All this was mentioned very clearly in the Quran and the Sunnah. Therefore, the Muslim should not have any differences. There are minor differences which is allowed. And this because, you know, of social and custom, it's okay. But when we talk about the main rules, there should be no differences between Muslims. And this is what, alhamdulillah, happened. So all Muslims, they have no differences regarding the articles of faith in Islam. A matter of aqeedah, all Muslims are agree in the same aqeedah, the same book, the same qibla, direction of prayer. These differences that we see it, and how to do this, should we raise our hand, should we keep it, all these are mostly our optional acts, and because people, they took one side of what the Prophet ﷺ taught. For example, the Prophet ﷺ sometimes he hold to show them that this is Sunnah. Sometimes he doesn't. Why? So people, if they see him all the time holding, they will think it is must. So sometimes the Prophet ﷺ leaves certain thing to show that it is okay, it's not must. Like for Salat al-Taraweeh, when he came, 3 nights pray, when he noticed that people, they start gather and pray behind him, he stopped coming to lead them. Why? To, you know, it will not be must on them. They don't think that it is must. So some, this is why, my dear brothers and sisters, we should understand why there are some different, you know, differences in Sunnah. So now among Muslims, some people who hold, it's okay, no problem, that's in the Sunnah. Some, they don't. Their prayer is okay. And they think that they are following the Sunnah. But always the Muslim should follow what the most sound evidence of the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Wallahu yahdi man yasha. Allah guide whom He will. And so the guidance is from Allah. Now, what the application of this, my dear brothers and sisters, that we always ask Allah to guide us. And Allah taught us clearly in Surah Al-Fatiha that we should repeat this dua, اهدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Guide us to the straight path. We already guided, alhamdulillah. But that means keep us in this guidance. So the Muslim in every prayer should ask Allah to keep him. Why? As you know, especially at this time of fitna, this time, yani, it is very difficult for the Muslim who want to practice his faith. Why? Because many desire, many temptation, many idea, many philosophies that confuse even the wise person. So if Allah Azza wa Jal did not keep us on this straight path, the person, little by little, maybe he will deviate from the straight path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used in every sajda that he said, mostly he said, Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deen. Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers, she asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she said, O Prophet of Allah, I see you, I noticed that you always repeat this dua. O Allah, who turn these hearts, control these hearts, keep my heart on your straight path. He said yes, because if Allah, everything is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He turned the hearts of the people to the way that he wants. Therefore, we ask him always to keep us in the straight path. So this is dua that you need. You need always to repeat it. And this is what we do in Surah Al-Fatiha. طيب, let's go now to some of the lesson that we learned from this ayah. The first one, as you know, Islam is the original religion from the beginning, which means all people were born on the straight path, in its nature, al-fitra, and their community is the one who may. طيب. The wisdom of sending messenger is to warn and give glad tidings. This is the purpose. This is the function. This is the wazifa, the function or the rule of the messengers, to tell the one who is doing good, you know, the happy news that he will be rewarded, and warn the other that be careful. You should repent before you die, because otherwise you will be loser. Prophethood is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not by, you know, by choice of the person, or he can ask Allah for it. Allah Azza wa Jal choose that whom he wants subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a blessing, and this is honor for sure. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى آدَمَ وَنُوحًا وَآلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَآلَ عِمْرَانَ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose Adam and Noah and the family of Abraham and the family of Imran. So he mentioned some of the family of Noah, because all the prophets come from the descent of Noah. And then the family of Ibrahim, because all the messengers who sent after Ibrahim, all of them from his offspring. And Ali Imran, as you know, this is related to Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, because Imran is the father of Virgin Mary. طيب. Regarding this also, prophethood as a gift from Allah, the Arabs, you know, and one of their objection when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was come to them, they said, this man, he is an orphan, and he's, why Allah did not choose one of the two great men in the two towns? You know, they want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, to choose for them one of their leaders. قالوا لولا بعد. So the town, that's mean Mecca or Taif. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered them, أهم يقسمون رحمة ربي, are they the one who divide or give the mercy of Allah? نحن قسمنا بينهم معيشتهم في الحياة الدنيا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who gave you and divided the blessing to everyone. So it's not to you to decide or to tell Allah to whom he chooses. So it is blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very point, you know, important point, interesting point. Why? Nowadays, many of the Christian missionary, they go to Africa, Asia, different places. They say, we are missionary, we are giving the mission, the good news, you know. And this is what they say. In fact, they are not. They are misguided people. They took some Muslims from Islam, the straight path, worshiping one God, to turn them to worship Jesus, or, you know, Trinity, subhanallah. So the real missionary, the real one who's given the true mission, who carry the real mission, are prophets, and those who follow the way of the prophets, like the disciple of Jesus Christ during his lifetime, like the Sahaba, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, following exactly the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Unfortunately, those missionary Christian mission, they are taking advantage of the poverty and the needs of some Muslim communities. They go to Africa, Asia, find poor, needy people. They are in need for water, for education, for health care. They provide this. But for the purpose, they took their children, put them in school, raised them as Christians. Because they know their father, their mother, they will not accept Christianity. So they work on the young generation. And this is why you see Christianity spread in Africa, Asia, and Indonesia. Because of this work, while it is misguided, may Allah Azza wa Jalla protect us from their plan. Rules and laws that come with messengers are commands, are prohibitions. That means whatever Allah command, we should do. Whatever He prohibit, then we should stay away from. Books are revelation that come down from Allah. And in it come down, that means He is the most high. So He is sent down because He is the most high. So He sent these books. And every messenger, as we said, was given a book to rule during his lifetime to his nation. Till the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came, his book, the Quran, overcome all the other books. So no one nowadays said, okay, I am following the book of Moses, the Torah. We said, yes. But the Torah was updated. This is a book of Allah, but the last version has come with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran. So the Quran is the last revelation and overcome all others. And nobody should follow any other book. Umar radiallahu anhu, one time he was reading the Torah, some paper from the Torah. Just a matter of curiosity. He's curious. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him. What did he say to him? He said, oh Umar, if Moses was here now, he has no choice, no other choice, except to follow me. Which means, now for all Muslims, you know, it's not lawful, by the way. It is not permissible for the Muslim to read the Bible or any other religious book, except for a person with no wisdom and knowledge, and he with a fair knowledge of the Quran, so you'll not be confused, and be use it only for the purpose of da'wah. Otherwise, or interesting, or a matter of pleasure. No, it's not right. The people should turn to the book of Allah for judgment when they have dispute. As we said, explain that we should return, turn back to the Quran and the Sunnah. If there's any differences, then we should look to what the proof. What's the source of this proof? Either the Quran or the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending this kind. This is a great mercy from Allah. Just to show you how merciful is our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just imagine without these messengers and after long time from the time of Adam, people, if they were not shown the way to Allah Azza wa Jal, but they will go. All of them, they will go to hell. But it's explicit from Allah Azza wa Jal that he sent us guidance. It is the nature of people to have differences. This is something, you know, natural. But the most important thing is that the person should not be stubborn, should just, you know, insist on his opinion or his view or following the pattern or the model of his family, you know, even it was not right. The wise person should verify the evidences, proofs, and then he should choose the truth. People will reach agreement and harmony if they turn back to the book of Allah, for sure. If we have one guide, then there will be no difference. This is why, my dear brothers, at this time, as you know, they said, the whole world, the whole globe, turn to small village. And to show you this, the wisdom, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last messenger, to be universal messenger. The Quran as the last book for all mankind. For all mankind, not only the Arabs. Just imagine if the whole world believed in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and follow the Quran, they will find him in harmony and very few defenses like what we will see now. Condemning those who turn away from the revelation of Allah and have dispute about it, for sure. You know, and you know the reason is why. Sometimes because of their desire or because of their power or whatever. Differences and dispute among people is not a good sign. Why this mention? Why we mention this as one of the benefits that learned from this ayah? Because some people, they say that the differences among Muslims is a sign of mercy. Or the difference, different views of ulama, that means ulama had different more than more opinion is a mercy. That's not true. And there's a hadith, you know, which is people, some people depend on, they said, اختلافوا أمتي رحمة أو كما ورد. But in fact, based on this ayah and based on many ayat, difference is not a sign of goodness. In fact, the best thing is to have agreement. Anyone who turned away from the truth was misguided, as we mentioned in that bid'ah. One should follow the truth when find it, even it was different from what he used to follow. This is the meaning of submission, to accept, not being stubborn. The mercy and favor of Allah for believers that he guided them to the truth. For sure, this is a mercy and blessing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us on this straight path. True faith leads to the truth. If you truly believe in Allah sincerely from your heart and give the judgment always to Allah, then always you will be led to the truth. This is why always we, the Muslim, always whenever he wants to do anything, even sometimes something he like it, he want to do a business, he know that this is this bargain or in this deal, would there be a lot of, you know, maybe he will gain a lot of money. But then he said, okay, but I'm not sure. Is it lawful or not? Is it interest, riba? Is there anything wrong? So he asked ulama, why? So when he asked, he turned to his faith, because his faith led him, you know, not to follow any way or get any money from any way, but go back and check to make sure that you do the right thing. So this is always this true faith, sincere faith, always will lead the person to the truth. The level of faith determines how much one is close from the truth, same as the one that we mentioned. And one should always pray and ask Allah for guidance, as we mentioned in the dua of the Prophet ﷺ and Surah Al-Fatiha. Anything away from the teaching of Allah is a deviation and leads to misguidance, as we mentioned in the hadith. People in terms of their stand with the truth are of three types, as mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Al-Fatiha. Remember, we talked about this, explain it in detail in Surah Al-Fatiha. People are either accept the truth the straight back, or they are ignorant about the truth, so they are lost. Lost, misguided, because they don't have the truth. or those who are stubborn, third group, stubborn like the Jew, who know the truth but they don't follow it. They think they are the chosen people of God, and this is why they don't follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. طيب I think this ayah also will take some time from us, and it's already the time is 2:10. I don't like to take more of time, so let's leave it for next week inshallah. I think what we study today is enough, and we'll leave some time for your question. Barakallahu alaykum. If there's any question, yeah. Any question?
Assalamu alaikum.
From the chat box, we don't have questions. Yes, Sister Amina, go ahead.
Yeah, and this, just this, can you further clarify? True faith leads to truth. I didn't get it very clearly, Sheikh. Thank you.
Okay. When we say true faith, that's mean the believer, he give up all his desire, all his own view, and try to follow what was revealed in the revelation, either in the Quran or the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, nowadays, for example, you find among some Muslims, there is some differences. Like, for example, some they celebrate the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they argue with you from the point that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet Muhammad. You see, people, they celebrate their own birthday. So why we should not celebrate the birthday of the most beloved one to us? You know, it's they think this is the logic. And if anybody, any Muslim, he doesn't have knowledge, he'll say, oh, that makes sense. Yes, why I should not celebrate to show my love for her? So, but here, if the person go back to his faith, what does the faith say? What does your belief say? The belief said to you, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Then, as a believer, you will go back and check, okay, does the Quran approve this? Does the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam approve this? The Quran said, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever the Prophet taught you, take it. Whatever he prohibited you should not do it. Then, okay, I go then again to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ to look. Okay, did the Prophet ﷺ celebrate this, his birthday? Did his family celebrate his birthday? Did his companion, who loved him more than anybody else, even more than themselves, during their lifetime, celebrate this day? No. For the first three generations, 300, three centuries of Islam, Muslims never celebrate the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This start in the beginning of the 400th year after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when some innovator, they come with this argument to Sufism, they said, we love the Prophet, let's remember his day. And it started very, as we say always, they put the seed of innovation. They said, we just remember this day, we get together and to mention, read about his history, about his life, about his mission, and remind people about him. And then gradually, till it's come to a big celebration, as you see nowadays, in many, unfortunately, Muslim countries, that they had even, you know, they have celebration and they have lambs and they have, you know, a lot of gathering for this. And they say, we do this to please Allah. How come you please Allah from something that He didn't command you to do? More than this, He told you not to do anything that He didn't, you know, mention to you in the Quran or the Sunnah. So the person who turned to his faith, and follow the Quran and the Sunnah and believe in this, even he, you know, was different from people around him, from his community, this is the one that was led to the truth, and he was kept away from the misguidance. I hope this is clear.
جزاك الله خير.
طيب. Okay. Okay, since there is no question, so we'll stop here. See you, inshallah, next Saturday, as usual, to continue. بارك الله فيكم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.